Good evening, everybody. I'm thrilled to be with Senator Cardin, Senator Daines, and Senator Hassan. We're going to talk about the power of advocacy, the tremendous challenges facing small businesses, and the path forward. You all have firsthand experience in advocating on important issues. How has that experience informed your view of what makes an effective advocate? And I'd like to start with you, Senator Cardin.
Just think back a few months ago, within a very few days, we were able to pass the largest stimulus package ever in the history of the United States Congress. And the largest package was for small businesses. That small business program was a lifeline. It didn't just happen. It happened because small business owners effectively communicated to those of us in the United States Senate in-house how important it was for us to help them through COVID-19. So we passed a bold program, and it passed 98-0 in the United States Senate, 96-0 in the United States Senate. There was no opposition to it because of effective lobbying. So I was proud to be part of that. I was proud to be part of a bipartisan product that produced real results to help America's small businesses, to help their workforce, to help our economy. And to me, I'm in the Senate to get things done. It's for Senator Daines and Senator Hassan in the Senate to get things done. And your effective lobbying with us enables us to be able to achieve real results. And we did for the American people with the passage of the Paycheck Protection Program.
Thank you. Senator Hassan, can you talk a little bit about advocacy and, you know, what advice you'd give to our community?
Let me just say that I started my path to public life as an advocate. My husband, Tom, and I have two wonderful kids, the oldest of whom, they're both now adults, happens to have severe disabilities. So I began advocating for Ben in his school and then in our community and then at the State House. And one thing led to the next. And I became a state senator and then governor and now U.S. senator. And even though I have advocated for first my son and then for my constituents, I keep learning as I go. And I think that's one of the most important things about advocacy. It is important to be sure to tell your story and to underscore what Senator Cardin said. The fact that you all did so effectively this spring made all the difference in our capacity to get the Paycheck Protection Program passed. And Senator Cardin and my senior Senator Jean Shaheen deserve enormous credit for that. But it's also important as you tell your story so that people can see how a certain policy or legislation is going to impact you and have a ripple effect in your communities. It's also important to do your groundwork, and that's why being on the Hill is so important. Groundwork means touching base with other stakeholders, with people who may be affected by your proposal, and hearing them out and engaging in dialogue so that the ultimate solution you're proposing will be effective and sustainable.
And Senator Daines, how about you? Comments on this topic of advocacy.
Yeah, well, my background began in small business. I grew up in a construction business of less than 20 employees. So I used to watch my parents as advocates trying to work on some of the public policy items back home in Montana. But I tell you, David, thank you for putting this together. And I want to thank my two esteemed Senate colleagues as well. I just teeing off, I saw Senator Cardin talking about results. I think that's a very important part of advocacy is focusing on what the outcome of results is. And Senator Hassan said the same thing about this, you know, outcomes and results and focus on that. What is it we're trying to achieve? What's the ultimate benefit that we want to have as a result of our advocacy? Take the policy and then make sure we translate that into outcomes and results. I'll tell you from an advocacy viewpoint, with the PPP program, we turned into advocates as senators. Once it passed, there were a lot of rough edges on it. It was very fluid. I was in the software business for a number of years. It's like sometimes you introduce software, there's a few bugs in it. We had to work that out with subsequent release, administrative changes. And I am so grateful for our small businesses using Zoom and these virtual meetings. We were all kind of in lockdown. That feedback was so important. And here I am, a kid from Montana that grew up there. I'm on my patio, my home in outside of Bozeman, Montana, on my cell phone, directly communicating with Secretary Mnuchin on very specific administrative details that we needed changed on behalf of our small business back in Montana. And it was very fulfilling to quickly loop back with our small business that just spoke with Secretary Mnuchin. We're going to get this change made administratively. It'll make a big impact on eligibility for PPP. We're working as a great big team, virtually 24/7, but the ability to clearly articulate what the outcome is that's needed is really important for advocacy. And it was very rewarding to see some of those changes made and to help these small businesses during a very, very difficult time.
Senator Cardin, you know, shifting back to you, you had just talked about how the Paycheck Protection Program was a truly bipartisan bill, an example of what can get done when both sides come together. In a complex situation where people have truly divergent or competing interests, how do you get people to work together, listen to each other, and drive toward a common goal?
Senator Rubio, the chairman of the Small Business Committee, Senator Collins, senator from Maine, Senator Shaheen, as Senator Hassan pointed out, her seatmate in New Hampshire. The four of us sat around the room and we listened to each other. And we recognized there were some common threads here. The businesses in New Hampshire are different than the businesses in Florida, that are different than the businesses in Maine or in Maryland. But there were some common themes here. And we recognized that, yes, we have an obligation to save businesses, but we also want to save jobs. We want to keep people employed. And if we can keep people employed, we can preserve a small business being able to come back when our economy comes back. We can also save taxpayer dollars with less unemployment benefits and less unemployment insurance costs. We could put all that together in a common way. But we had to be bold, and we recognized that if it's going to work, we couldn't ask small businesses to incur additional debt. They really needed the financial help to keep their workers working. And that's where the Paycheck Protection Program came out. We listened to each other. We had different views. There was different views on the size of the businesses. There were different views on how to deal with nonprofits. But we listened to each other. And we were determined to be successful. We were determined that America needed us to succeed. And I think almost every legislator is there to get things done in a positive way. And when you do that and you hear, listen to what people's views are, you listen to the small business owners, you take pride in reaching the finish line, getting something done for the American people.
Senator Hassan, I want to go to you now. Can you talk about why small business owners should be front and center at this time? Why is that so important?
You know, in New Hampshire, 99% of our businesses are identified as small businesses, and they employ about half of the workers in our state. What I know is that small businesses not only often spur additional economic development in our small communities, certainly in my community, it was a small bookstore that started about 25 years ago that all of a sudden you saw one business after the next pop up in the same block, right? And so they're critically important as catalysts, I think a term you also used earlier. But they also know their customers, they know their communities, they know their employees, and they know them in all these different aspects in a way that makes them natural advocates for many layers of interests and concerns. They are also able to change either the way they're doing their business or what they're focusing on very quickly. And that's something we've seen in the COVID-19 response over and over again in New Hampshire. There are so many stories in New Hampshire, small manufacturers, for instance, who changed their whole product line to create personal protective equipment at a time when our frontline workers desperately needed it. So when we're talking now about the steps we've taken to add flexibility to the Paycheck Protection Program, our capacity to do that was because small business people came to us and said, well, this is how it's working. This is how it's not working. By the way, I've got an employee who's in this particular situation or a customer or a vendor who is having this difficulty as well. We can get more information often from small business people than we can get in terms of a sense of what's happening on the ground than we can get in any other way. Also, the other thing is small business people are often volunteers, either on nonprofit boards or in New Hampshire on many of the governing commissions that we have. And so they just bring a wealth and a depth of information to us at critical times and help us make better decisions.
That's terrific. Senator Daines, you know, even as businesses begin to reopen, They are facing a multitude of challenges, fewer customers, lower revenues, additional costs. Is there a discussion about the possibility of allowing small businesses applying for a second round of PPP funding? And would you be supportive of an idea like that or something similar as this continues on?
Very much so, David. I think what you just articulated there in terms of what we've seen, the fewer customers, lower revenues, additional costs related to protective measures, that's a case in point of what advocacy does to help us better understand what the real-time situation is. We can make sure that the policy decisions we're making here are relevant and actually solving a problem we're seeing in the front lines of small businesses. I was happy to be introduced with Senator King of Maine, the Senate version of the Paycheck Protection, that Flexibility Act that we just passed, the president signed last week. I remember it was Ranking Member Cardin who was working really hard to help everybody get that across the finish line. And, you know, that original 96-0 vote we saw at the end of March, when everybody from, you know, Ted Cruz to Bernie Sanders, I mean, when is that going to happen? We're all on the same page. Why? Because we faced a moment in our history where Congress had to move fast. And then this adjustment we made, this flexibility at the PPP, that's a direct result of the feedback we got from our small businesses. And they told us, hey, it's not going to be 8 weeks because the uptake's going to be slower than that here to get back to some degree of normal. And that's why we extended that to 24 weeks. We took that 75% limit, took it down to 60% just to give a little more. It's really trying to get the right size of shoe for the right size of foot. And that's where the reality is at the moment. And that's why it's so important we stay closely connected to small businesses, because you know what? It's a very dynamic situation. And no doubt the way we see it at this moment in time will be very different in 4 to 8 weeks.
Thank you. Senator Hassan, I want to turn to you now, and I want to talk a little bit about leadership and leadership in a time of crisis. The small business owners joining us this evening are leaders in their businesses and leaders in their communities. As the pandemic has progressed, they have faced incredibly hard decisions around business planning, temporary closures, layoffs. What advice do you share around how to lead during a time of crisis and uncertainty?
I talked a little bit about how many different business leaders stepped up and continue to step up in New Hampshire as we're dealing with the pandemic. They hear about a need for PPE, or they hear about a family in need, or they have employees who may be struggling for any number of reasons. They've got either themselves and or their employees have children at home learning remotely while they're also trying to keep the business afloat. And they're also taking this leadership role in responding to the pandemic, stepping forward. I think what's critical is to focus when you have these difficult challenges. And the hardest ones are when there's just no really good answer, right? No matter what you do, you are going to be faced with a downside and or with criticism. So you do what's right for your community, for your business, for your family. And what I have seen time and time again is that when business leaders are clear and transparent about what their challenges are and how they're trying to meet them, you will see their customers and their community rally around them just the way the businesses have rallied around their customers and communities too. And that's, I think, what's so important here is be clear with people about the challenges you're facing. Be clear with them, your customers, your employees who may be directly affected by a layoff decision, for instance, about what you're doing and why. Be as creative as you can and problem solve with them. One of the things going forward is that we need to keep talking about is the possibility of bringing people back part-time while they still can get under the terms of our unemployment changes, some unemployment benefits. We all are going to have to be creative. But when you are honest and clear and you are clear about what you're trying to achieve and who you're trying to support, your customers and your community will rally around you. And I think the ripple effects of that are great right now, but also in the future.
Thank you. Thank you for those words. It looks like we're out of time. I want to thank all three senators for joining us today and for their tremendous advocacy in support of small businesses across the country. Thank you very much.